The Rape of Sonic by Lam Powell, Sonic Lover 66. Chapter 1.
It was a rather normal day in the bustling city of New York, but that mattered not to the energetic and exuberant young hedgehog. Sonic had just ordered a few chili dogs from the local vendor, and was having a quite swell day all in all, if not quite boring and average. Suddenly, as he just finished his third chili dog, the goofy, rather handsome blue hedgehog noticed the sight of Rouge the Bat, strolling slowly, rather methodically towards him, swaying her hips from side to side, nearly mesmerizing him. He shook his head, avoiding the lewd thoughts that came within his brain every time he saw Rouge approach. After the methodical intrusion by Rouge, she was face to face with Sonic by this point. Her well-rounded hips stationary, Sonic himself trying to avoid contact with her other assets. She lifted one of her supple gloved hands to his lips, wiping off a trace amount of chili, then reaching to her own moist wet maw, licking the chili from that gloved fingertip. With a pop, she relinquished the finger from that sopping hole, sending a chill down the blue hedgehog's spine as he watched in awe.
"It is quite a lovely day, wouldn't you say, darling?"
Rouge said, batting her eyes lightly towards the already enthralled hedgehog. It was quite obvious that Sonic was already Play-Doh within her leathered grasp. Sonic managed to finally regain himself, speaking swiftly.
Yeah! It really is an awesome day, Rouge!
Rouge nearly giggled after hearing Sonic's stuttering and excited tone of voice, realizing how weak he is to her current charms. After about 15 minutes or so of light banter, Rouge's body language and seductive tone had begun to drive the hedgehog mad. As much as he attempted to contain his desires, his facial features showed obvious lust as he began sweating and mumbling over his words progressively more and more as the conversation continued. Finally, the beautiful bat decided to pursue Sonic, saying with confidence and seductive undertone,
"Would you like to get out of the seat, Sonic, and come back to my apartment with me? Perhaps we could talk more?"
The hedgehog's eyes widened at the question immediately, but he simply nodded his head rapidly as he found it difficult to get words from his mouth in this heated moment. Rouge and Sonic had eventually made it back to her apartment. It was only a few blocks from their previous location. The street was rather busy, the honking of horns loud and rather obnoxious, but this wasn't relevant to either of these heated individuals. Rouge led the way, slowly stepping up the stairs, forcing the already fawning hedgehog to observe every sway of her hips. The tight leather against her soft skin, stretching and contracting around her spacious ass. A light slit even visible through the tight leather between those thick hips she possessed. Eventually, they reached their destination, but Rouge put effort into making it as slow as a walk as possible to drive Sonic even more wild before allowing the hedgehog into her home. Finally, they reached the passage to her apartment. She caressed the bronze knob of the large door, slowly wrapping her fingers around it and twisting. A pleasant click was heard as she pressed the door open. Sonic had wondered why the door wasn't locked. Did she plan this ahead of time? But those questions were swiftly tossed away as he entered the dark apartment, following Rouge like a lost puppy. As Sonic began stepping inside, it was as if time had slowed down. Trapped in his own lustful mind, pondering over what would occur next, he was nearly trembling with desire as he thought of pressing his gloved hands against her bulbous rear, ripping the fabric away, and having his way with the vulnerable bat.
End of chapter 1. Chapter 2.
Shortly after Sonic and Rouge had stepped into the dark corridor of her apartment, the door shut slowly with a creak and gentle thud. Though Sonic had become nervous as he was made aware of a shadowy figure ahead of him encased in the darkness. With another subtle click, the light had turned on. He was now face to face, eye to eye, with his rival. Shadow the Hedgehog. Rouge swiftly pulled a key from between her cleavage, locking the door and using her body to make sure Sonic couldn't escape from in this now awry situation. Sonic's immediate reaction was to begin running towards the exit, but there was no escape as Shadow began speaking.
Chaos!
Horror flooded through the now flushed face of Sonic the Hedgehog as he realized what was about to happen. A tear nearly escaping his eye as he realized how helpless he truly was at this moment.
Control!
Shadow had let out a chuckle to himself as he realized the blue imposter was now completely vulnerable to him. He grabbed the now stationary hedgehog like a rag doll, pulling him into the rather pompous and luxurious bedroom, simply to chain him to the bed, offering little to no hope for his escape. Suddenly, reality snapped back. Sonic swiftly looked around, in horror, immediately beginning to scream as his eyes filled with tears. But Shadow only responded with gagging him. Using a nearby pair of used boxers, Shadow had came in recently, stopping the faker from screaming for help. Rouge casually strolled into the bedroom, nearly as if she had done this before, having little to no reaction to the now helpless and crying hedgehog. Shadow had pondered to himself, if this harsh revenge was worth such a precious chaos emerald. But that thought had quickly swept away, as he enjoyed seeing the hedgehog already in so much misery. Rouge then spoke up after entering the room, taking a quick glance at Sonic, then back to Shadow, uncaring about the now bound victim.
Where is the crystal, my Shadow? I agreed to get Sonic here. Now I want my pay.
Sonic was shocked at how Rouge sold him out so easily to this awful punishment, beginning to whine and scream harder, trying to alert someone around him. Rouge then heartlessly punching him in the stomach to shut up his helpless cries. Shadow begrudgingly handed the Chaos Emerald to the slutty bat, smirking as he thought to himself about how he would simply steal the crystal back eventually. After Shadow had given the bat her payment, he looked down upon the vulnerable and fighting hedgehog, trying his best to escape to no avail, as each of his limbs were tied to the long post of the queen-sized bed. Shadow slowly licked his glistening lips as he felt himself beginning to unsheathe at the sight of the completely unwilling Sonic. As Shadow was completely lost in his thoughts of how he would devour this fine blue morsel, Rouge pressed her now unveiled rounded breasts against his muscular back, grinding them lightly as she reached her gloved hands to his now erect cock, veins bulging along the shaft as Prey began dribbling down onto the carpet. Shadow's excitement clearly shone through his body language.
It's a shame you saved this beautiful cock for that blue swine. I could have such a lovely time with it,
she whispered into his ear in a seductive tone as she began squeezing along the bulging shaft, nearly milking more prey onto the floor. Shadow ignored the comments of the Chiropteran seductress, his veined black cock not pulsing from her, but from the thought of completely splitting open that blue hedgehog. Sonic stared for just a moment, thinking he was going to be tortured by the duo, but not this. He realized now how severe his situation was, salty warm tears flowing down his cheeks, as his face grew pale, adrenaline rushing throughout his body as he tried to escape, violently to no avail. Rue slowly trotted over to the cabinet nearby, pulling out a bottle of lubricant. But Shadow scoffed at her as an evil smile crept along his face. Rouge knew immediately he was fully dedicated to ravaging poor Sonic, and nearly felt bad for him as she put away the bottle swiftly. Shadow bit his lower lip, a light bit of drool flowing down his maw, dribbling down his chin as he climbed onto the bed with a near spring in his step. As he knew what was coming next, he wrapped his large gloved hand around the base of his gigantic black dong, a red stripe going down the shaft into the head, his prey now leaking onto Sonic's smooth quills. He gave Sonic no time to prepare, as he slid the head of his cock downward towards his puckering hole. Sonic tensed the muscles in his rear, trying to prevent Shadow's entrance, but offering no positive results for the blue victim. Shadow forcefully pressed his cock into the resisting hole of Sonic. Sonic tried his hardest while screaming and crying to push out the giant-veined cock, but Shadow pushed back twice as hard, nearly instantly going balls deep into the dry hole, the only lubricant being the copious amounts of pee leaking from the head of his cock. He moaned out deeply and pleasurably as he felt the blue faggot's tight hole squeeze around him, just making him want to ravage the hedgehog even further with his mammoth-sized black cock. Shadow began fucking the hedgehog relentlessly, sliding that veined cock in and out quickly, penetrating his throbbing paint hole over and over, giving him no rest as the tears continued pouring from Sonic. Eventually, he screamed and cried so loudly, the gag became loose, and he spat out Shadow's improvised gag. This angered Shadow greatly as he continued fucking Sonic's now slick with pre-asshole. Feeling it throbbing around his massive cock as he grabbed onto Sonic's neck, he choked him violently, balling up his other hand into a fist, beginning to punch the blue prick's head in fiercely, giving him a nosebleed. Sonic not even being able to scream properly whilst being choked and fucked so brutally. "Scream again and I'll actually begin to get rough!" He punched the victimized ragdoll once again, giving the already blue hedgehog a nice purple eye. Ruse the Bat spoke up as she felt her own pink walls begin to ooze warm, sweet liquids, it even trickling down her legs slowly.
"I know something that'll gag him well, darling,"
she said with blatant lust and want, radiating from her vocal cords. She slipped off her tight leather garments, her supple ass jiggling immediately, as the clothing that was conforming to her skin was removed. Her now revealed pussy began leaking onto the floor, leaving stains that would more than likely take days to remove. She eagerly hopped onto bed, removing Shadow's hands from the bound blue ragdoll and replacing them with her oozing hot hole. She began forcing Sonic's lips against them, making him taste her as her juices poured into his mouth. Sonic continued trying to protest, but to no avail. Slight muffles and tears seeping from him as he felt like passing out at this Shadow spoke up to Rouge, anger and frustration in his voice, as he kept pleasing his bulging monster with the blue sex toy's hole.
"I know you have something better that can shut him the fuck up!"
With reluctance, the Bat pulled herself off the blue male, but making sure to grind her tight asshole against his nose as she lifted her wondrous, soft, now sweating body. Slowly, she trotted to the other side of the room, once again opening a dresser across the bed. Sonic's now half-opened, lethargic eyes growing wide again with fear as he saw Rouge holding a vinyl horse dildo at least 25 inches in length. And thicker than his asshole, and thicker than his own throat. Shadow's huge cock splitting his asshole open was one thing, but taking a horse cock down his throat? That seemed simply impossible. Rouge walked delightfully back to her plaything, Immediately cramming the head of the flared dildo down his poor throat, Sonic felt as if he may die at this very moment, as he felt his throat stretching more than it ever should. Being completely suffocated as she relentlessly began stuffing that huge horse dildo down his pulsating wet tube, Shadow still violently fucking the blue bimbo's asshole, not easing up whatsoever, only going harder as Pree was the only lubricant Sonic would get. Rouge occasionally yanked out after 30-second periods, only to keep Sonic alive for more torture, making sure he got enough of his precious oxygen. Sonic began to feel every inch of Shadow's pulse and cock enter and exit him vigorously, but suddenly, it became even more painful as Shadow's cock bulged even more, pressing against his blue prostate as the veins along the black and red hedgehog's massive black cock swelled, beginning to absolutely explode inside of Sonic as a torrent of cum splashed into his hole. Shadow began relieving his huge, pent-up black balls into the blue cum dumpster that was Sonic, filling him to the brim, cum bursting around Shadow's huge cock and leaking from the tight hole. Slowly, Sonic gained an ounce of hope, believing this may be over now, considering Shadow had his fun. But it wasn't over. Shadow chuckling to himself as he simply pulled out, only to release some of the liquids from the submissive's hole before going at it again, fucking deeper and even harder than last time, his raging boner progressively getting harder within the throbbing hole. Rouge simply continued gagging Sonic's throat with the horse dildo. Sonic completely gave up calling for help at this point, nearly passed out, possibly dying, but Shadow and Rouge wanted to make sure he felt every second of this. Sonic at this point had completely given in to his captors, allowing them to simply use his now ragdoll-like body. The only thing emitting from his still writhing body was a few whimpers, and the occasional tears. But that only turned Rouge and Shadow on progressively more and more, simply making them more relentless in their sexual deviancy, trying to milk more amusing reactions from their captured prize. Sonic had nothing to say after hours of being fucked every which way, even passing out occasionally for a few minutes. But then, being harshly awoken by a smack from Rouge or a punch from Shadow, trying to make him suffer as much as possible, as the bed below Sonic was becoming soaked in a mixture of cum, sweat, saliva, and tears. The mixture of liquids causing a strong scent to flow through the air. This being the final blow to Sonic, the stench combined with the brutal fucking and treatment causing him to fall unconscious for the rest of this night. Shadow continued fucking his limp body even after the blue hedgehog slut had already passed out, pretending it was Sonic's corpse, but grew more pleased as he felt the breathing of Sonic, knowing he could have some more fun in the times to come. After around a week of torment, Sonic began to seemingly accept his fate. Losing nearly all hope of rescue from his friends or the police, he was anally prodded, forced to give oral, cook and clean for them, and every other deprived act you could fathom. Eventually, Shadow left, leaving the blue cum slut behind to squabble in his now defeated nature. But Rouge stayed with Sonic, continuing to use him as her personal slave, for at least months to come, using him to clean up her trash and then force him to clean up her pussy after. Rouge was proud of what she had created, a simple little cum dumpster to be used whenever she liked. She would even bring over some of her bigger male friends to have a go at her new boy toy, even going so far as to bring animals to use him as well. She wanted to see him completely broken, and she had succeeded. She made him nothing but a brain-dead servant for any master willing to lay claim to that blue ass. But Rouge at least kept her pet dressed properly, leaving him neatly clothed in a maid outfit daily. Of course, it typically ended up torn and ruined after the end of the day, but she always spot him a new one to keep her slave looking nice before being raped progressively more and more. But in the end, it stopped being rape, and Sonic began enjoying every second of his dominant captor and all the friends she had fucking him weekly.
End of chapter 2. Chapter 3. Amy and Dale sat serenely on a grassy hill, looking up at the sunset, the sky being beautifully pink as the sun crept its way down. Dale's grew a light pink blush across his face as he reached his gloved hand to Amy, glancing up at her, then looking away swiftly. Amy found his antics rather endearing and adorable, so she obliged the small two-tailed fox and held his hand tightly. Slowly, Tails grew a saddened expression, looking up to Amy softly with those big eyes, and asking in his high but sweetly pitched voice,
"Amy, why do the bad people always get so far in the world?"
Amy's expression stayed simply the same, a rested look about her. With half-closed eyelids, she placed a soft kiss on the fox's forehead, continuing to grip his hand tightly, reassuring him he will be all right.
"Dale, that's a difficult question to answer. Sometimes, we can't control the things that happen to us. And other people, it just happens, and we have to live with it. But I promise, Dale, you'll be okay."
She sweetly smiled to him after speaking her serenading words. Tails couldn't bear it any longer, and he rested his head on her side, closing his big eyes slowly and resting his overactive and sweet mind. Amy simply placed her hand on the back of Tails' head, stroking down his fur softly, relaxing the worried fox. Amy pondered to herself if she could eventually confess her love for the young Tails, perhaps leading to something more than just his close friendship. Only time could tell for the two, and what would result of their intimate affection for one another. End of chapter 3. Chapter 4. Knuckles had recently caught wind of a Chaos Emerald in the city, sensing its seething power. He soon realized that it was coming from a rather tall building, seemingly an apartment of some kind. It was definitely a wealthier part of town, so Knuckles had presumed it was someone that simply bought the Chaos Emerald somehow, possibly a collector, or something different entirely. The echidna pushed away these thoughts swiftly. The person withholding such a powerful gem didn't matter. The only thing that mattered was retrieving and securing it. The muscular red echidna passed onward along the sidewalk to the front of the complex. He pressed the door of the building open with his muscled hand, slowly trotting inward, observing his surroundings keenly. Eventually, he spotted the stairs, walking towards them and ascending upward once reaching the first step. He was growing closer to the source of the energy, stopping on the second level, finding his ways to the door. He was certain this was the location. He balled his muscular gloved hand into a fist and knocked firmly onto the door, not the type to immediately trespass when attempting to get what he wants. Finally, after a few more knocks, he heard mild shuffling coming from within the home. He stood stalwart, awaiting an answer, growing more and more impatient as he knew it was his duty to retrieve this powerful relic at all costs. The door suddenly swung open, Knuckles' eyes opening wide, perplexed at the sight before him. A blue hedgehog, adorned in what seemed to be French-made attire with subtle stains.
Sonic, what are you doing here? Why are you here?
Knuckles shouted demandingly. Sonic only lowering his head submissively and stepping to the side, allowing the sensual bat to trot over, swinging her hips from side to side, breasts bouncing delightfully.
"Oh, Knuckles, how unexpected of you to arrive at my humble abode,"
she uttered near delight in her voice, giggling after her joyous sentence, resulting in her breasts bouncing hypnotically.
"Have you come for a drink, or something more, darling?"
she said while resting her feminine gloved hand over his strong red chest. Knuckles remained unenthused by these actions, swiping her hand away as she looks nearly offended by his stone-cold facial expression.
"What have you done to Sonic? And more importantly, what have you done with the Chaos Emerald?"
He spoke with a might and command in his voice, not falling for her feminine wiles whatsoever.
Oh, Nucky, how disappointing. I was hoping so much you would have more on your mind than that silly little crystal. Tsk, tsk.
She was blatantly disappointed, always wanting to go with the muscular red male, but having her advances denied each time.
And as for Sonic, he's just my little plaything by now. Don't worry about him. He surely doesn't.
Methodically, this response was trickled from Ruse's lips, unconcerned about her blue slave, and more concerned about what the action Knuckles would take to get the crystal from her. The red hunk could sense the crystal radiating energy from within her apartment, and he simply shoved Rouge to the side, having no care for her pointless dribble. He wanted to help Sonic, but the Chaos Emerald had to come first. Rouge attempted to protest, but hadn't enough time before Knuckles had already entered her bedroom, nearly smashing open her closet to reveal a thick metal safe. He knew where the crystal was located. He balled up his muscular hand once again, but prepared to strike. It only took him a few moments to bust through the weak, in comparison, metal box, seeing the Chaos Emerald inside and taking it into his grasp quickly. The echidna trotted his way out of the bat's room, triumphant in his quest to find one of the remaining Chaos Emeralds not in his possession. It was now time to aid his friend Sonic.
You know it's rude to go through someone's personal items without asking, Knucklehead.
The beautiful bat boasted, immediately attempting to kick the echidna to the ground with her strong leg, the heel of her boot nearly reaching Knuckles before he simply put out his hand, grabbing her leg and tossing her to the other side of the room, bloodying her face and bruising her body.
Sonic, we have to get out of here!
Once again, the response of the blue hedgehog was nothing. He was simply another one of Rouge's sapphire gems. Knuckles knew Sonic was too broken to do anything without being forced, so Knuckles had decided to finish off Rouge somehow. He had to get revenge for his friend. He stomped with purpose towards the now completely vulnerable bat. She tried her best to stand, but was pushed down under the sheer force and muscle of the echidna. He gripped into her clothing firmly. With one strong yank, it was all but gone. The bat was now truly vulnerable to the echidna's whim. Though Rouge protested slightly, she wanted this, and knew deep down her lust hungered for him greatly. His muscular red form overpowering her juicy plump rear. Just imagining being slapped by him made her throbbing walls ache with desire. But Knuckles wanted nothing to do with the bat. He simply wanted to punish her for the atrocities she committed against Sonic. He had already decided he wouldn't use his thick crimson cock to ravage this needy slut. Her rounded rear now being revealed to Knuckles. He spat on his fist to lubricate it enough to fit before lowering it to her now puckering hole. Rouge spoke up in horror at the sight of Knuckles preparing his fist behind her. Sweating his fear, she whimpered out,
Knuckles, you can't do this. It won't fit. I'll be killed.
But the protest meant nothing to the muscular echidna. He punched his fist into her dark star, the large spiked glove splitting open her pained tail hole. He retracted it out after his fist was fully engulfed by her hole, only to ram it back in once again, repeating this process until her puckering gape was nearly as big as her own head. Sonic watched, nearly expressionless, still standing patiently by the door, awaiting new orders from his mistress. As he watched Knuckles fisting her, though, he began sweating through his fur as he felt something rising beneath his black and white skirt. Nearly lifting it as his blue boner began launching upwards. His cock couldn't help but dribble pre at the sight, it falling from beneath his dress onto the ground, desiring to be used by Knuckles, and abused by Knuckles. At this point, Rouge was knocked unconscious from the sheer agony racked throughout her body. Knuckles saw no point in continuing this action if Rouge wasn't even awake to suffer it, so he retracted his fist and stood up from the still-breathing unconscious bat and began marching towards Sonic.
taking him by the hand and walking from the apartment building out of it and escorting him away from the complex.
End of chapter 4. Chapter 5.
Knuckles ran with Sonic as quickly as he could, bringing him back home. Once they arrived at Sonic's house, the door was locked, but the red echidna simply punched his way into the house. Once they were both inside, the Chaos Emerald and Sonic safe, he felt as if his job was finished. But his good nature stopped him from just leaving. He felt he had to help the Blue Hedgehog. In a firm voice, the echidna spoke.
Here, let me help you get out of that outfit.
Knuckles then slipped him out of the demeaning but erotic attire, leaving the hedgehog in his normal state, or at least as normal as he could get at this point. The muscled red figure realized something after a few moments of being in the home. There was no one else here. Amy and Tails were nowhere to be seen, and a lot of the furniture and items were missing from the room. He assumed they may have moved, but why would they? These would be questions for another time. The echidna then slowly lifted Sonic in his arms, bringing him to the bathroom and laying him in the porcelain tub, calmly running the water. Sonic remained mostly silent during this whole ordeal, almost as if he was constantly in a daze, unable to wake. He accepted the treatment from the dreadlocked male, feeling Knuckles begin to wash warm water all over his bruised and even thinner than normal body. This treatment made the abused hedgehog's cock begin growing erect, unable to help himself after being used as a sex toy for so long, and even beginning to enjoy it. Just the slightest amount of kindness aroused the hedgehog, making him want to reward the large echidna for saving him from his captor. Sonic leaned his head over the edge of the white porcelain tub, pressing his mouth submissively against the echidna's sheath. He began to use his warm and yet muscle to lick across it, trying to incite even the slightest amount of pleasure to make his crimson cock appear. The blue cum dumpster placed one of his gloved hands onto Knuckles' firm waist. Knuckles, unable to resist the licking, Sonic saw his gigantic crimson cock unsheathe, realizing it was even bigger than Shadow's.
What are you doing, Sonic? We can't do this! This is wrong!
He barked. Sonic remained silent like he has been this entire time. Sonic knew when a man wanted something by this point, and Knuckles wanted him. Knuckles' cock fully unsheathed itself as a result of the submissive licking, his balls dangling proudly below the absolutely massive shaft. Sonic then wrapped his hand around the base of that bulging cock that was big enough to even make a horse jealous. He pushed his warm maw against the head, sucking it in, his tongue dancing around the rim and slit. A blush began streaking across the already red face of Knuckles, just making it even brighter shade as he enjoyed the sensual reward for rescuing his friend. This, along with the Chaos Emerald, was enough to make anyone jealous. Sonic responded to his blushing only by taking his cock deeper, allowing it to slide down his warm, muscular throat expertly, not gagging even once. A chill shot down Knuckles' spine as he saw the hedgehog look up at him with his gorgeous green eyes, his only response being to place his muscular hand on the back of the blue hedgehog's head, pressing him down further on his now throbbing and dripping cock. Sonic's saliva was now nearly coating every inch of the massive red cock. He could feel every inch throbbing down his sopping wet throat as he took the echidna as deep as possible. When he reached the base of that beautifully sculpted four-tipped cock, he began licking at the proud sack dangling below it, extending his tongue as best he could to massage the beautiful crimson jewels that Rouge wished she could handle. Sonic moved his gloved hands to Knuckles' defined ass, gripping it firmly as he began bobbing his head up and down, feeling the throbbing shaft slide in and out of his wonderfully hot and wet hole. As Knuckles felt his cock being engulfed fully by the hedgehog, he couldn't help but begin moaning deeply, his voice echoing through the bathroom as he felt his gigantic, veiny dong being pleasured by the little submissive Sonic. It was all enough to put him on edge right then and there, but just as Knuckles thought it couldn't get any better, the Sapphire Hedgehog dipped his gloved hand into the warm water, getting them soapy and hot, only to place them on the echidna's large dangling sack. He began tugging and massaging at those wonderful crimson orbs as he bobbed his head up and down repeatedly over the gargantuan red shaft. Knuckles' legs nearly buckled under the intense pleasure he was feeling. The wet hands, the hot maw. It was all too much to handle. His strong hand gripped onto the spiny blue hair of Sonic as tightly as possible, holding himself up as he was pleasured so professionally. Knuckles realized how much Sonic really trained during his time as Rouge's captive, and perhaps it was worth it. But after just a few moments, the echidna couldn't restrain himself any longer and let out a pool of cum into the hedgehog's mouth and throat, his body nearly going into a spasm as he felt himself unload those gigantic red testicles into that beautiful hole. Sonic didn't choke whatsoever on the massive load, being well trained to take such large torrents of seed. Sonic, after cleaning off Knuckles' freshly relieved rod, let it slide out of his mouth and flop between the red echidna's legs, a trail of saliva following from the hedgehog's lips as it fell downwards, the veins still bulging along it. Eventually, it found its way back to the cozy sheath. Knuckles, at a loss for words, nearly collapsing onto the ground after being pleasured so well.
Sonic! I don't know what to say!
After a few moments, the echidna emptied the bathtub and dried off the submissive carefully. He proceeded to wrap the towel around Sonic's freshly cleaned body, leading him to the bedroom after, and allowing the poor blue soul to rest a while after his long captivity. Knuckles had no idea what to do from here, where he should go get help for Sonic, or where to find Amy or Tails. He couldn't just leave his friend alone in this situation, and made it his next mission to find him aid. End of chapter 5. Chapter 6. Amy and Tails were walking home from buying groceries. Amy, of course, carrying the primary load, while Tails was gently hovering next to her, carrying a slightly smaller bag in one of his gloved hands. Amy turned to Tails as they walked down the rather quiet and serene street.
Tails, you're the genius. Why do we have to die so young?
Tails looked down for a moment as he thought, then placed his hand on his chin, scratching lightly as he pondered over the question.
Amy, that's a hard question to answer. I guess that's just how we are made, or how we evolved. I wouldn't worry about it too much, Amy. If you spend your life worrying, you can never enjoy it.
Tails smiled towards the pink hedgehog softly. Amy quickly turned her head to Tails, placing a quick kiss on his cheek. Then simply continuing to walk forward, Tails began blushing furiously after the kiss, nearly wanting another one, but he shook his head and just kept hovering back home. Soon enough, they had traversed back home, placing all of their groceries into the sizable refrigerator, simply relaxing on the couch and watching TV after their short trip. End of chapter 6.
Froggy! Bye bye!